enemies, 11 or 13. One of which is a sectopod, one of which is an Archon. Couple of mutants and shield bearer plus normal advance. Have I researched Skull Mine? No, not yet. I need to upgrade it. It's one of the things that we would need to do. Good, here we go, guys. 12 rounds. Wow. That is far. Look at that. We need to go over this whole building, then go over here, and then go over here. So, naturally, let's start to get over the building as fast as possible. And then we're going along this route and basically going there. So the shortest path is through the building. Anakin, please lead on. Hopefully we're not going to be spotted out by some damned civilians. Apparently we're not. Let's aggressively move on, because we will have a long, long time to run. Good. That works out just fine. Which tells us we can double move. Vengeance allows us to take plus 3 movement in the first 2 rounds. No, it's not called Vengeance. I don't know what the name of the skill is, but we have skilled it, so as long as we stay concealed in the first 2 rounds, we're effectively having plus 3 speed, which is nice. Let's just see what the heck reward would be. Okay, so that's huge. That is our life insurance if things are going wrong. Mwah. What's the best order of buildings and researching? Taizuka, first and foremost, welcome to the stream. And if you scroll down a little bit, you will see Saiken's guide for XCOM 2. You will find most of the answers that you're asking yourself probably in there. So how about you're just reading through it, give me some feedback if you liked it, and if you still have questions afterwards, I'm happy to answer them. We're going to approach them this turn, by the way. No. How about this? Okay, we could go there, but it would take away the concealment, which is kind of pointless, considering that we would want to have concealment, right? Right. If we go up here, we don't want to waste the EMP bomb yet. That's going to be reserved for the sectopod. We want to go up here and maybe take a little bit of a normal grenade. Nah. These guys are not going to move anyways, and they can't go into cover. He is going to be able to probably kill all of them. So if we break concealment now, it might look like a pretty stupid move, but I want to keep him still as an option to regain abilities in case we're pulling more packs. And I'm pretty sure that we can finish them with our sniper. So yeah, we're breaking concealment, which means we're just being revealed. But we do have a good position. So both of them are overwatching. They're always starting to overwatch. Sorry, I was turning down the microphone. I seem to be living next to fire department. I wasn't aware about that when I moved in. But yeah, that's what you are currently hearing. So we could now face off. Could also go for this move here, which would flank him so we can kill him with a shotgun. And we wouldn't need to worry about the Overwatch because she ignores Overwatch generally. Good, here we go. Nice little extra shot. Yeah, I think we have that under control. We're just using fan fire and killing this guy, which is three shots. Nice little extra damage. We will be able to pull this one off without using a mimic beacon. We're just using cooldowns for now. So yeah, two advent heavy advent max and one shield bearer down. So that's three down and 10 more to go. Unfortunately, the fan fire is gone for now, so hopefully we're not encountering the sector pod right away. Advanced scope is cool. Advanced speed is also good. Yeah, that was a pretty nice loot. We are going to slow down just a little bit. Because of our cooldowns. I don't want to trigger something unnecessarily. Again, wonderful 100% hack reward. That's just awesome. Wow, still so long to run. That's borderline broken. I am taking a longer leap here because it's still a long way to go. Good. Time for an Overwatch. And I think timing-wise, we're pretty much okay. Still got most of our cooldowns. We want to get over here. We hear a sector pod stomping. So I would be surprised if he's around here or maybe even up here. But again, we can't really wait and see how this one is going to turn out. We need to aggressively engage. Yeah, master sector pod. Master sector pod. Hello there, friendly sector pod. How's your personal well-being today? Good? Oh, that's lovely to hear. How about we have a little conversation about the things that I do not enjoy? Is he stunned? Is he stunned? Is he stunned? Perfect. Shut down. Don't want to get the extra action. Not this turn. We will get there sooner or later, but not this turn. Good. Threat assessment. Wonderful. We still have our mimic beacon and we're going to use it this time. So let's shred him. We do have Shredder on her, which is great. It's just a bonus way to deal even more damage. That plus armor penetration netted 14 damage on him. Great. Just great. So now we can take extra shots. And next turn, he will be dead. I just wish we would have a little bit more accuracy on our Overwatch shots. Don't kill it. Don't kill it. Fuck you. Lance has got a lance, baby. Latouse dodges like a boss. And Bladestorm. And burning. And fear. And running away. What? What? So she apparently blade stormed him. He went on fire, then couldn't hit, decided to go here and then overwatch, then take a shot. Since when can they run and gun? There are moments in time when I hate that game. It's really true. Good. We're starting with a Stun Lancer here. Okay, I just wanted to soften him up, but apparently he decided to die instead, which is generally cool, but yeah. Nice one. Nice one. Good. Anakin moves up. We took some damage, which I didn't like. But yeah, I think overall still reasonably well fought. So that's three down, four down, seven, which will mean we do have two more packs of twos probably. Right, Latouz takes a sneak peek up here. Did we still have the faceless ones? I'm not sure. But yeah, we're pushing it to the limit now. What's the fastest way to get in there? Probably we just blow away all of this. Drop down, get him, and get to the evac zone. The other alternative is to normally use the door, but who uses doors? Storm. Yes. Mutant, please. Blightstorm. Counterattack. What the fuck? Good, so we're moving up here. And the reason why I could be that aggressive is I knew we're still having the get out of jail card for free. So, everyone apparently has another action. And Mutant, let's talk about that one thing you were just mentioning about my mother and how you counterattack, right? Shotgun to the face? Yeah, pretty shitty, right? I do agree. So Latouz could go a little bit closer, and then he would be in range to for a 100% shot. 96, but that's close to 100. Question is if we're going to get him down fast enough. Fire pistol. 7 is a good start. Lightning hands. Yeah, the game doesn't really like lightning hands. Okay, 3. I can live with that. And Fanfire. I was about to think whether or not it would have been a bad idea to just grenade him. But I was like, nah, Saiken, really? Grenading him? That's not needed. You have 96%. Heading there now. Good. At least Anakin does his job. Kills him. And could even start to move up. Close enough to 100, yeah. XCOM should teach you there is no such thing as close enough to 100. It is either 100 or you need to rethink what you're doing. Let's aggressively go down here. Okay, that works out well. Still need to open it next round, by the way. If you're just unlocking it with your hacking skill, it will not count. You need to see the VIP in order to extract it. Gosh, I need to take a 30 seconds break. And have you just seen the last packs here? It was shortly visible. Be right back, 30 seconds. All right, here we go again. Gents, it is time. We have 5 more rounds. Everyone's low on ammunition. Perfect moment in time to reload and rescue the VIP. Enemy protocol? Maybe. No, but a large cache of intel sounds like a very, very good idea. Good, so that's 40 intel on top of the 83 intel that we're getting. We need to reload. See, there's the pack I was talking about. But there's the exit zone, and you guys can be sure that we are just going to move up. And next turn, we're evacuating here. No point in fighting Archons and mutants if there is no need for it. Yeah, we're going to be successful. And I thought that this might happen, but we can remove his Overwatch. Well, hello there. We can kill this guy. Let's just kill the stun lancer. Or not. See you later, stun lancer. Okay. We're going to kill him, definitely. Nice execution. Good job. Yeah, might be a hard target, but you can deal up to 33 damage with your pistol. Yeah, target neutralized. Good job. VIP gets the fuck out of here, and Wet Latouse ends the mission with a miss. In typical manner, Wet Latouse says, I have scored that many hits, now it's time for a miss at the very end. Yeah, probably I have miscalculated on two packs of two. It was one pack of three, but it was the last pack. I hate VIP missions so much. Dark VIP missions are the worst, but VIP missions are also not very cool. One pack was reinforcements, so yeah, three of them were reinforcements, but the other three were a normal pack. Archon plus two mutants was the last pack. And Fanfire apparently is a very, very nice and handy skill to have on a four-man team. So I like the idea of having it. And I'm even considering it to take it over Serial. Serial is great, but Fanfire made our life like so much easier against the hard-hitting targets. Plus, it's a cooldown that refreshes quite regularly. She still got no promotion. 20 missions, 72 kills. Like, she's the kill leader of all of them. And by the way, he has started earlier and with less missions and way, way, way less kills, he still is on the right while she is he already finished while she's still on the right. I can't understand it. 40 intel plus 83 intel from her. Couple of loot, that's good. Here, 82 intel. Our 12th engineer. Assorted loot is good. That could be anything from PCSs or weapon modifications. So it's basically free loot. Again, we just need to wait a little bit longer, so probably two more, one and a half more months until the Psi operators are ready. We've started them very late. We started them very late, and that's why it takes so long. No, the mobs do not give different amount of XP. There is an XP system, but the XP system is disabled. So every mob gives you exactly 1 point of experience, and it just require the number of mobs that you kill is relevant. Nothing else. There is a UFO. I don't want to fight the UFO, so we're just gonna get some gonna go somewhere else. I don't want to be shot down. That will be a 1.5 hour mission. Completely unnecessary at this stage. Let's finish the loot up here. Assists give XP, that's true. Snipers get 1/5 of assist kills. So they are the slowest class, whilst rangers get 1/4. So they will get one kill for every four kills that the team is doing. And the fastest ones are specialists. Nice one. Look at that. We get a colonel specialist for free. Andromedon, okay. Viper, elite trooper. Only one sector pod and a couple of codices, but we can deal with that. I think we have no more sharpshooters that we can train up, right? That's a luxurious problem to not have enough sharpshooters to train up. We could get Lumberjack here, but he's a fucking corporal. I don't know. At some stage, you need to cut it. We're taking our team here. We're getting these guys here to corporal level, to colonel level. So that's fine. We're going to level Ghost. We're going to level Kotov. And Latus is the last one that gets a level. Good. So that team is equipped for, still from the last mission. We could go for some more fancy armor, but I think that's not necessary. B-Shift, yeah, you're psionic character this time, my friend. I'm thinking. Well, we can evac. Let me just take a look. Which enemies did we have? Vipers, okay. Elite Troopers, Andromedon, Shield Bearer, Codices, Elite Officers. Let's just change the loadout a little bit. She gets the Rage Suit and the Fusion Blade. Good. And since I enjoy the suit so much, let's give him the Icarus suit. It looks nice. It's just super awesome. I love it. Good. And Serpent Armor. Good. That looks like a team. Like a good team. I want to test something. So I haven't tested it in a while. We haven't used the bolt plasma launcher. And I just wanted to give it a try and see if it is still viable. Good. Shredstorm cannon. Yeah, here we go.